first. So just coming into your mountain pose for our warm up. Feet hip width apart, toes straight ahead. And just get that core connected, shoulders relaxed, everything stacked for support up through the crown. And then as you inhale, bring your arms out to the sides. Exhale, hands to your chest, stretch forward, and exhale, fingers behind you, clasp together. Lift your heart and pivot over. Exhale into that forward bend, hands toward the ceiling, tuck in your chin. Just deepen into that forward bend as much as your back wants this morning. And breathe. And then on an inhalation, chin in, sitting bones down, slowly wind your way back to the top and lift your heart. Press your hands down so that chest opens up nicely and stretch your spine. And then inhale to the top, release your arms. Take a moment to feel your body. And again, inhaling, arms reaching out, hands to your heart. Stretch forward and exhale behind you, clasping those hands the other way, fingers one over. Lift your heart, stretch your spine, and exhale over. Come into your forward bend, hands toward the ceiling, head down toward your legs. Lift your sitting bones maybe for that hamstring stretch and breathe. And then knees bent and chin in. Slowly wind your way back up and heart high, head back, shoulders down, opening across the chest. And on an inhalation, come up and release. Take a moment, feeling your spine a little bit more energized. And inhaling, arms out to the sides, palms toward the ceiling, over your shoulders. Tap your hands and clasp them. Bring your arms back by your ears. Shoulders down, sitting bones down, and lean over for your side stretch. Press out through the fingertips and the top of your head and down into the foot you're leaning away from. Get those ribs apart, stretching out. Inhale back up. Switch your hands around. And again, shoulders down, sitting bones down, lengthen up and lean to the opposite side. Get those ribs apart, lengthening through the top of your body. And again, inhaling up, exhale, and release. Just take a moment feeling your sides and your spine, a little lateral motion. And we'll do our twists, so remember, sitting bones and crown away from each other. As you bring your arms up, stretch it out, palms toward the ceiling, and then arms right over your shoulders. Clasp your elbows, pull the arms back by your ears, sitting bones down, stretch the spine, and exhale for your twist. Keep the knees a little soft, keep the weight on both feet, stretch on the breath in, and pivot.
As you come into your forward bend in the twist, relax there for a few moments, seeing if you can keep the weight even on both feet. And then slowly work the way up and lift your heart, pull your elbows back, shoulders down. Again, breathing, lifting your heart, maximizing that upper body back bend, not your lower back. And then inhale upright. Exhale to the center and switch your arms around. Shoulders down, sitting bones down, crown high, and switch to the other side. And again, breathing in and pivot over. And as you come into that forward bend, just take a few moments to check that everything is even on both sides, keeping the weight on both feet. The knees may be a little soft, so you're not overworking them. And again, just breathe, lengthening your spine. And on an inhalation, come back up. And again, heart high, over the head. And stretching into that upper body back bend. shoulder blades down. And again, inhale, look right. Exhale, back to center, arms up. Let's bring the arms to shoulder level, chin and chest leading. Keep your back flat, and then drop into ragdoll. Take a moment there, just breathing, or pull in a little deeper with your hands behind your legs. And when you're ready, just exhale, arms back to the front, and slowly work your way one more time back into mountain pose. And as you get there, just take a moment to feel your spine more energized, ready for your practice. So we're going to use the chair, might as well start with it. So let's go ahead and put your chair. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to hold onto the chair and take a good step back. Get your feet hip width apart, toes straight ahead, and then hands are right in front of your shoulders. So you should be about as far back as the length of your torso plus your arms and your hands just on the top of the chair. Then we're going to drop the chest down, drop the chin and chest toward the floor till your arms and your ears are at the same level. And then just push the crown forward and the sitting bones back and keep the chest dropping maybe a little bit further. Take a moment to breathe. Exhale and just relax through the armpits, through the chest. And then tuck in your chin, bend your knees, and walk back towards the chair and into mountain pose. So take a moment there, feeling your spine, feeling your body, just kind of noticing how that's working. And then we're going to turn the chair, or you don't have to turn the chair. You can just sit. I'm turning the chair, so no, I guess I'll leave it that way. Okay. So sit on your chair with the back not touching the bottom of the back of the chair. Sitting bones connected, knees under your ankles. Toes straight ahead, and we're going to take the hands and clasp them behind you, behind the back of the chair, so fingertips together, and then pull your whole back onto the chair and push your hands toward the floor and lift your heart toward the ceiling as you look up. And if you need to, you can tip your chin back toward your chest so that back of your neck doesn't crunch too much. Keep pushing the knuckles toward the floor behind you, getting a good chest opening, heart opening at the front. So this is really good if you've been working at the computer, and you can do this right at your desk chair. So stretch your head back, sink into the sitting bones, lift your heart, and breathe. And then chin toward your chest, release your hands back to your lap, and sit back up with your back away from the chair. Take a moment, feel the circulation. It's probably going to maximize right about that shoulder blade area. So just be aware of how that feels. And we're going to do the same thing, but with the fingers clasped the opposite way. So just shift them over one position behind you, opposite finger outside. And again, pull your back to the chair, lift your heart, push the knuckles down, and reach your head toward the wall behind you, or tuck your chin a little bit more if your neck is bothering you in that back bend. Again, the feet stay hip width apart in front, right under your knees, and the chest opening is your focus. So shoulder blades on the back of the chair, and the heart lifting high toward the ceiling. Keep breathing. Keep stretching the head back away, spine nice and open, sinking into the sitting bones. And then again, chin towards your chest, release your hands back to your lap, and sit back upright. Again, take a few moments, just feeling that circulation, a little bit more energy through that heart and upper chest area, upper back area. And then bring your leg out straight, right leg out straight, one leg out straight, and straighten the knee. So you may have to slide forward with your sitting bones a little more to the edge of the chair to get your legs straight. Flex the heel and pull the toes back toward you. You can hold on to the chair if you want or not, your choice. And then we're going to lift that leg with the heels pushing away and just bring it up until it's about the same level as the seat. And then if you want, kind of pull your kneecap toward your quad and tighten your quad a little bit and lift the leg maybe a little bit higher. Press out through the bottom of your foot. And then bending your knee, bring the foot back down and into place. Take a moment to feel the difference on that side compared to the other leg. And then slide the other leg out, press the heel away, get it nice and straight. Hold on if you want or not, and bring that leg up till the thighs are about parallel and that's about at the same height as your chair. And again, kneecap toward your quad, front of your thigh tightening, and if you want, raise the leg a little bit more, pushing out through the heel and the bottom of your foot, and then slowly lowering back into place. Take a moment again, just noticing how your body responds as you do that. So we're going to hold on for the next one. It's a little bit more abs-y. So again, get your sitting bones connected. We're going to lift the foot off the floor and extend the leg straight. Bend your knee and put the ankle on the opposite knee, above the opposite knee, letting that knee come out to the side. And then pivot forward with your back flat, sitting bones kind of sliding back toward the back edge of the chair. And just use that core for control as you come into that forward bend. So leading with your chest and your chin, back of the body as straight as feels right for you. So the point is not to get your knee down to your leg. The point is to keep things as straight as you can. And if you don't need to be holding on, that's okay too. And then pivot back up with your upper body. Bring your knee back, legs straight to the front, and put it back on the mat. Again, take a moment to notice how your body responds to that work. And then bring your other leg out and up. And again, flexing the heel, bend the knee, bring that leg, foot onto the other leg, knee out to the side. And again, keeping your back as straight as you can, pivoting from that hip joint, leading with your chest and chin, come forward toward that leg. You don't need to get there. If you do, that's fine, but you don't need to go all the way down toward that leg. Keep your back straight, shoulder blades toward your waist, and crown and sitting bones stretching away. And again, inhaling, pivot back up, bring that leg back to the front, and put it back down. Take a moment, breathe, feeling your body, noticing how the core is feeling, maybe a little bit more energized. And then slide forward till your sitting bones are just barely on the chair. And hold your chair with your hands right under your shoulders, fingertips toward the outside. Get your weight into both feet evenly. And we're going to slide the sitting bones just off the chair. And if that's enough for your arms for strength, you can stay there. Or you can do a little tricep dip, bringing your hips down toward the floor, and then pushing back up and sliding your body back onto the chair. So again, keeping your back as straight as you can through that process, keeping the weight on both feet evenly, and just sliding the knees toward the toes, not too much beyond, just getting your body off the chair, dipping down, pushing up, and sliding back onto the chair. And release. Take a moment just feeling your arms and shoulders, noticing how your whole upper body feels. Take a moment and breathe. And then we're going to pretty much stay there. You can hold on to the chair if you want to. And we're going to bring one leg out straight, flex the heel, and then we're going to pivot forward toward that leg, again, keeping your back nice and flat. So a little hamstring stretch. So think about the kneecap going toward the quad tightening along the front of your thigh. And then pivot back up and slide that foot back into place. Take a moment, again, noticing how that side feels. And we'll do the other side. Slide the foot out, flex the heel, push that foot away, and hinging at that top of the thigh, hip joint, pivot forward with your back nice and flat. And again, just stretch through the spine as well as the leg, and pivot back up. And slide your foot back into place. Okay, holding onto your chair, slide both feet out, flex the heels, keep them as straight as you can, kneecaps toward your thighs, thighs tightening, hold on, and again, chest and chin forward, leading, pivoting toward your legs as far as you want to go. Push through the heels, through the bottoms of your feet, through the crown, sitting bones back toward the back of the chair, holding on so you just don't slide off. And then pivoting back up and bringing your feet back under your knees. And again, taking a moment, feeling your body, noticing the circulation. Take a moment to breathe. And then we're going to do a little balance practice. So this one you can do on the floor with blocks, or you can do it with the chair. So we're going to hold on to the chair once again. And we're just going to lift the body off the chair and bring one leg up. So there's pressure in your hands. Be gentle if your wrists are having an issue. And then back down. Take a moment, realign and reposition. And again, press up off the chair, sitting bones up, and bring that other foot up. Keep that core engaged. The more you engage the core, the more it helps you. And again, back down. Now, core engaged, we're going to do it with both feet. This is much more challenging. If you've got a wrist issue like I do, it may be a little bit too intense. Just sit back down if that's the case. So again, keeping those legs as perpendicular as you can, we're going to press up off the chair and see if you can get your feet both off the floor at the same time. Okay, I can't do that one. But if you can, that's great. And back down. And take a moment again, feeling your upper body, your core, and noticing how all that is working for you this morning. And then we're going to sink into the sitting bones, lengthen up through the spine. Bring one hand to your opposite knee, other arm out in front. And as you exhale, bring that hand around and grab the far side of your chair if that works for you, otherwise just the back. And then keeping the hand on the knee and the sitting bones both evenly down, stretch up through your spine. Exhale, turn your whole body looking toward the chair behind you. So breathing, exhaling into your twist. And remember, lengthening through the spine, making sure that your whole body, not just your head and neck, move into the twist. And then releasing your hand from the chair, bring your body back around to the center, and take a moment, feeling the twist energy all through your spine. And of course, we're going to do the other way. So hand to the opposite knee, other arm out, and exhale it around to hold the back of the chair as far around as you want. Again, lengthen up through the spine. Exhale, turn toward the chair behind you. Whole body turning, hips, ribs, and shoulder. Sitting bones evenly into the chair, crown reaching toward the ceiling. Maximize or minimize, remember personal practice, your twist, your body. And again, as you breathe and relax into it, maximize or minimize for your body. And then bring the hand back up, shoulder level, follow it back to the center, and reposition on your chair. Okay, feet under your hips, feet under your knees, hips straight back, arms in front. We're going to do the chair squat. So this means you're going to push into your feet and just lift your sitting bones off the chair, coming forward with your back nice and flat. So holding that, feel your quads, your legs. Don't go too deep. If you need to, you can push up a little bit further. And then we're going to stand all the way up and into mountain pose. Take a moment, feel your body. And we're going to use the chair for a balance practice. So if you're using the chair for your balance, just bring it to the side and arrange your foot so that the outside of your foot is parallel to your chair. You don't have to hold on to the chair if you don't want to. You can just be in a regular balance practice. So get the whole band base of your toes all the way across, big toe end, little toe down. Spread your toes out, no gripping. That raises that base of the toe area, gives you less support. Heel down, arch lifting, so that whole bottom of your foot is connected, whole body stacking up, and your body in that position. Nice and straight as you can. So we're going to be working from the hip joint and keeping the body as straight as you can, warrior three. So core engaged, bring that navel back toward your spine, the whole midsection, solar plexus, engaging to keep you nice and supported. Spread your toes, get your good support, hold your chair if you want to. We're going to pivot at the hip and bring that leg slightly back behind you, flex the heel, and then we're going to keep the whole body parallel as you pivot forward. So lead your chest and chin coming forward. You can have your hands back by your hips if you don't want to be holding on to your chair, or you can have them out to the sides. Or the hardest way is with your arms overhead along next to your ears. So from the side, the pivot is at the hip, the whole body is straight, and you're coming forward, chest even to the floor, hip bones even to the floor, so that everything is parallel. Pushing back through the heel, out through the crown, arms at your sides, out to the sides, or overhead. And then slowly pivot back up and into mountain pose. And if you're using your chair, you're going to want to move the chair to the opposite side. So again, line up first. It's really important to have that alignment before you get started. So that's an inner rotation for the side to make sure that your ankle, knee, and hip line up. Shoulder right above that. Kneecap toward your thigh, thigh tightening. Whole bottom of your foot, remember, getting evenly connected all the way across the base of your toes and everything. Hand to your chair if you want or not, your choice. Again, the pivot is at the hip. So bring that other foot slightly back, flex the heel. Keep your body nice and flat and straight as you come into your pivot. So chest and chin leading, that leg going up straight in the back, getting as parallel to your chair as you can. Arms back, position one, out to the side, position two, overhead, position three. So make your choice where you want your arms, or you can keep holding onto your chair. So remember, hip bones facing the floor evenly, shoulders facing the floor evenly, chest and chin toward the floor. You can tuck that chin a little bit and get the neck nice and straight as well. Breathe out through the crown, out through the bottom of your foot, lengthening. And when you're ready to release, it's again a straight pivot up, coming back to standing mountain pose. Take a moment. Feel that balance practice. Notice your core. The more your core was activated, the more it helps to keep that body nice and straight in your balance practice. And I think we're done with the chair for today. So go ahead and move that to the side. Take a moment as you come into mountain pose at your mat. Hands to your heart, looking at them. Inhale, bringing the arms up. Swan dive forward, nice flat back. Exhale all the way down into ragdoll. Hands sliding up onto your shins. Get that halfway up stretch, flattening and straightening through your spine. And then bend your knees and come on down all the way into child's pose. Hips back on your heels, forehead toward the floor, shoulders rounding forward, and just take a moment to relax. Deep breath, exhale tension. And then inhaling and sitting up, come into staff position, legs straight out in front of you. So sitting bones connect, spine stacks, shoulders right above the hips, hips, knees, and ankles straight out in front, toes up toward the ceiling, whole bottom of your foot pushing away evenly. So we're going to keep the knees up toward the ceiling. So a little inner rotation from the top of the thigh helps to do that. And we're going to slide the heels in with the feet flat on the floor, knees straight up. So one more core work for today. Just focus on that core right at the navel section. Get it working. Hands, palms up. We're going to stay on the sitting bones and lean slightly back. So you're not going back onto your sacrum. You're staying on the sitting bones as you're in that position. So shoulders down, ribs in and up, core active and supporting you. Stay here if that's enough. Otherwise, one foot comes up a little or more or straight out. So kneecap toward your thigh if that leg is straight up. If your hip flexor starts saying, oh, I'm working too hard, lower the leg a little bit more or keep it bent. So straighten out through the base of the toes, up through the crown, and exhale the foot down. Stay there if you like the abs work or sit up and take a break. So again, make sure your knees are straight up. So if they're going out to the sides, that means you're not inner rotating at that top of the thigh. You want the knees straight up and going straight down toward your ankles. Hands, palms up, just to keep your shoulders released. Spine nice and straight, sitting bones connected. Lean a little bit more back to get that core engaged. And again, the opposite foot comes up a little, or parallel, or all the way out, your choice. Maximize or minimize, kind of spread out through your toes. Make sure that if you're starting to vibrate in the core, that you just go ahead and put that foot down when you need to. Keep those thighs about parallel to each other if you've got your legs fully extended. And again, exhale and bring that foot down. Take a moment to breathe. Sit up and take a break. Slide your legs forward and just exhale into your forward bend. And take a moment to breathe and relax. And then slowly sitting back up, we're going to roll back onto the mat using your core for support as you slowly come down into corpse position. Settle into the mat. And one quick final twist to get us ready for relaxation. Press your back down, arms out, T position, palms up or down, your choice. Slide the sitting bones toward your heels a little bit. Draw your heels in toward your hips, feet flat. Sitting bones toward your heels and lift your feet off the floor. Roll your knees to one side, turn your head to the opposite side, and maximize into your twist, whatever amount you are going to want this morning. Breathe, relaxing, just letting that lower back to this twist. Keep your shoulders and shoulder blades down for your middle back, and head turning for your upper back. Just relax. And heels toward your hips. We'll roll onto your back and get ready for our opposite side twist. So again, hands, palms up or down, your choice. Knees above your hips. And roll the knees to the other direction. Head turning toward that arm now behind you. And again, just maximize or minimize for your body this morning, whatever it needs. Take a breath. Just release any tension. Let the ligaments release along your spine, allowing your body into the twist however much it likes. Shoulders and shoulder blades down, head turning, knees as far toward the floor as they want to go. And then one more time, heels toward your hips, rolling onto your back and feet to the floor. Go ahead and slide into your corpse position. You can keep your feet on the floor with your knees a little bit together if your lower back would like a little rest this morning. Or go ahead and straighten your legs out if that's good for you. Hands, palms up away from your side. Let your shoulders release and relax as well. Deep breath, just letting your body sink deeper into that earth embrace. Lots of core work and spine work today, so let that whole torso relax. Arms and legs softening. Jaw and face as well, just relaxing. Deep breaths. Exhaling any tightness. Let your whole body grow heavy and soft, sinking into the earth embrace. And just allow Mother Earth to support you, allowing awareness of your body to release. And as other thoughts come to you, let those thoughts release as well. No need to remember the past or anticipate the future. It's your choice whether you pay attention to your thoughts. And at this moment, there's nothing to think about, nothing to do, but relax. Let your thoughts drift and your body sink. and allow your awareness to turn inward. Find the peace within. Let it fill you with peace in your body, peace in your mind. Just being peace. And of course, if you want to keep relaxing, feel free to do that for as long as you'd like. If it's time to reactivate for your day, just begin drawing energy and awareness back to your body, the room, your mind, your body. And begin moving gently as you become ready. When you're ready for your final yoga hug of appreciation, just press your back down, draw your knees toward your heart, and give yourself that good yoga hug. Let your body know you appreciate its work this morning for you and the work it does for you every day. And when you're ready to release, just sit back up and prepare for whatever's ahead for you the rest of the day. Thanks for joining me this morning. Hope that was an interesting